any moment now. Omar Sharif, Michael Aspel from
Hello.
London.
Nice
to see you.
Nice to see you too.
We've come across.
What are you doing in the street?
Well, we're doing a bit of filming here, because actually I popped over to Paris for the day to say, Omar Sharif, this is your life.
Oh my God, you're joking. This is extraordinary. What, were you waiting for me?
We've been waiting like criminals for some time. And Steve Kenneth, of course, was in on the thing anyway, and he knows that you are booked on the next flight to London. And that many people are flying in from all over the world to join you there.
How wonderful. Oh, it's wonderful. I'm very excited. Thank
well,
you.
I'm glad. I'll keep the book, okay. And we'll make our way to the airport.
Okay.
Well, Omar, no need for seatbelts from now on. We've made the journey. And a fine example of the old Entente Cordiale, old friends from the Lord's Taverners, Nicholas Parsons, Neil Durden Smith, Bill Tidy, Fred Rumsey, and John Price. And a lady taverner, Neil's wife, who whizzes around the world even more than you. She's just arrived from Florida because she really wanted to be here. Judith Chalmers. Right now, a brief reminder of how the son of a wealthy Cairo timber merchant found international stardom, packing cinemas with films like this.
Would you like a Russian cigarette?
No, thank you.
I promise you, it isn't drugs.
Well, even if it was, you'd have to find some other way. I don't smoke.
If I go away and leave you in peace, will you have dinner with me?
Yes, if you like.
It would be very pleasant for me.
Well, your British co-star there is now also a Hollywood favorite, and that's where we go now, because she would like a word with you, Julie Andrews.
Hello, Omar. It's a pleasure to be speaking to you again, though I'm so sorry that I can't be doing it in person. I well remember the film, The Tamarind Seed, that we made together. It was such a pleasure. The fun that we had in those cold, foggy days in London and those lovely, sunny days in Barbados. I enjoyed it so much. And I hope it's not too long before we all meet up again soon. God bless.
Warm thanks to Julie Andrews in Hollywood. Nice to see her again so soon. Now, back in Paris, I mentioned that quite a few people would be boarding planes for London tonight. People very close to you.
That's right, Omar. We've flown from Atlanta, Georgia.
We've flown in from Cairo.
And Dad, we just arrived from Montreal.
Yes, it's a family fly-in. Your son, Tarek, with his fiancée, Martina. Your stepdaughter, Nadia, with her husband, Hamed. And with her husband, Alexander, your sister, Magda. Now, Tarek, these days you are an advertising executive in Montreal, but 25 years ago, you shared the big screen with your father in one of his most famous films, didn't you?
That's right. I played the part of Dr. Zhivago as a child at 8 years old. And I believe Omar directed the part at the time.
In a rather moving moment as well. And here you are, real-life son of Omar, Tarek Sharif, aged 8.
Mother, who played? Well, your mother was an artist, you. She could make this common little instrument sound like 2 guitars. Your mother had a gift.
Perhaps she has got a gift. Would you like lessons?
I can't play it.
Well. Very clear diction there. Was your father pleased with your performance?
I think he was all right with the performance. It was off stage that perhaps a trifle less happy. The thing that strikes me most about it is I remember playing car in a brand new sports car you'd bought, and I released the handbrake and pranged it. Unfortunately, it wasn't the last of his cars I pranged. And
Oh, it could have been a Ford. It would have been terrible. Now, do you still allow Tarek to borrow your cars when you go to Paris?
Well, I don't have cars anymore. I haven't had the car for ages now. But Tarek has bust up a lot of cars. I know because I've had to pay for a lot of them. Bust up. But he's doing all right now. He can pay for his own bust up.
Well, Omar Sharif, this is your life. You were born in Alexandria on April the 10th, 1932, in a suburb nicely named Cleopatra by the Sea. Michael Shahoub was your name, and you're only 4 when the family moves to Cairo with your father, Joseph. There he is with your mother, Claire. Yeah. Sets up his successful timber business. That's you on a donkey inspecting the goods. And here you are, aged 8, taking your first communion. You go to the British Victoria College in Cairo, and when you leave college, your father insists you join him in his timber business. Now, Magda, you'd arrived on the family scene by that time. How did the partnership with your brother and your father work out?
A disaster. Really a disaster. He used to sell to people he liked, but the people who have a very bad credit in bank. And after 1 year, my father lost so much money, he said, go and make whatever you want, but please leave the business.
And you do. Age 20, with no big break on the horizon, you form your own acting company. But it still leaves plenty of time for you to be the young man about Cairo, as we've been hearing from an old friend. And if you look at that screen, Omar, you'll see a few sights and sounds to remind you of those days. There's the old city of Cairo, the famous bazaar, and that same friend, Marwan Labib.
Omar, hi. Great to talk to you. Do you remember the billiard club? Of course you remember. Omar, would you like to have a game? I know someone inside here who does.
This is Mustafa, your old friend. Mustafa Diab, the former champion and the owner of the club.
How are you, Omar? I used to teach you to play proper snooker, but women were always interrupting. We'd like to see you back here. All the same, just bring some of your ladies with you. Have a good evening, Omar.
We called it a favorite coffee house where one day the course of your life was changed.
A film director who was casting a movie walked in, saw you, and decided that you were just what he was looking for. But there was a wardrobe problem.
The film director saw a man walking down the street dressed exactly like this. He said to you, that's just what you should wear in the movie. So what did you do?
Well, he made a quick change and he caught a plane. He's flown in from Cairo, Marwan Labib. Now, the film that Marwan mentioned there was called The Blazing Sun. And when it was released in 1956, it broke all Egyptian box office records. You were to marry, in 1957, your leading lady, Faten Hamama, mother of Nadia and Tarek. Alas, constant separations due to work led to the failure of that marriage after 8 years. But here you are, together, in the film that packed Egyptian cinemas more than 30 years ago. The film represented Egypt at the International Cannes Film Festival, and the name of Omar Sharif was seen for the first time on the credits. Now, how did you decide on your new name?
Well, quite simply, I always thought or hoped that I would become known in the Western world. And so when I decided to choose a name, I decided that I had to choose a name that was simple for Westerners to remember. And I remember during the war, there was a general called Omar Bradley, an American general. And I thought, well, if the Americans can call people Omars, that's a good Egyptian name, I can use that. And then I thought of Sharif as the Western.
Complicated, but I think I understand.
I thought Omar Sharif was a name that people might pronounce easily. And
could have been Dwight Eisenhower,
I suppose. Very optimistic.
Yes. Well, certainly the name of Omar Sharif is one of a number brought to the attention of a famous British film director casting a multi-million Hollywood-backed desert epic. He asks for a photograph of you and casts you as Sharif Ali in the Oscar-winning Lawrence of Arabia, launching your international career. He talks to you now, Sir David Lean.
You know, Omar, the first time I saw you, I don't know if you know this or not, but it was on a small photograph, postcard-sized photograph, and I suppose your eyes stopped me. Next thing I remember about this, long time ago, 27, 28 years ago, something like that, I introduced you to Peter O'Toole. And I remember Peter saying, Omar Sharif, nobody's called Omar Sharif. I'm going to call you Cairo Fred. And Cairo Fred you were from that moment on. And then, of course, we worked again later on Dr. Zhivago, which I thought you were just wonderful in. Anyhow, to be quite blatant about it, Omar, I suppose you know, you're one of my favorite actors, and I'm very, very grateful that we worked together. I wish we had more parts to offer you. Good luck.
Thank you, Sir David Lean. And Omar, David Lean couldn't have given you a more superb entrance into world movies than this. A favorite moment for millions of cinema-goers, your first meeting with Lawrence of Arabia.